last time on House Silverfyre. Here in Sunspear at the tip of Dorne, Daemon has found his way in secret, changing his identity to that of Damien the Taroshi. Ah, there it is. Please be something good. A jar of Arbor wine. There we go, ladies and gentlemen. That's how we start. This is how we start. Enemies take you prisoner. Do they take my horse? Do they take my horse? You lose your jar of Arbor wine. Of course they take my goddamn wine, and they walk back in the fucking direction we were in. Might be able to hunt him down and give him what he deserves and claim the bounty for yourself. Then he'll hunt him down and execute the law. This is going to be difficult. Oh, sweet. Oh, yes. You see, this is how your tide turns. This is how the tide turns. Now we have some decent armor. Look at, we got male boots now. On the street, insulting their mothers. Wait here. So wait a minute. I'm actually fist fighting a group of guides here. Is this really wise? Hit him on the head. Oh, okay. There's one. Oh, very nice. Very nice. Come on. Up top. Bam. Oh, Damien is slow. Ha! Knocked you down. Kick. Oh shit. All right. I believe I have found our man. Standing by himself behind a building. He is called a nervous man. Oh shit. Come on. Don't let him hit Paul. Don't let him hit Paul. See when the... Oh. Oh, yes. Yes. Sir Loras Tyrell has gone south. I have delivered justice in the name of the king and the laws of the Reach. I must follow Sir Loras south, but that will have to take place in the next episode. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Mountain Blade, a clash of kings. Oh, I meant to zoom in on my character. I actually accidentally zoomed in on Paul there. Here we are back with our man, Daemon Silverfyre, and we are outside of the city of Ashford. And I must say, it looks incredible. Look at that. That can't be a moat. That has to be a river, right? That has to be a river. That can't be a moat. That looks way too large to be a moat. But it's huge. It's huge. Anyways, last time we left off, look, they got little farms here and everything. That's so cool. Let's ride up into Ashford here. Last time, we were heading south looking for our man, Sir Loras Tyrell. We successfully fulfilled the bounty on the criminal. What was his name? Alan the Bold or something? I've already forgotten. But we took out the fugitive, the convict. It wasn't too difficult. He wasn't that well prepared. Daemon here, a little bit more prepared than he was, but we took him out and we need to find our man Sir Loras Tyrell so that we can inform our lord that justice has been delivered. Just clipped through the gate there for a second. Wow, this is huge. I cannot believe that Ashford actually looks cooler than Sunspear does. That's ridiculous. Anyway, so what I wanted to talk about is the main reason why we're taking a stroll through Daemon, you better respect the laws here and leave your horse somewhere respectable. Where are the stables? We gotta find the stables so that Daemon can leave his horse Paul here in responsible hands. Because I don't think the townsfolk would appreciate him just riding around on his fucking horse. He is no noble lord. Unfortunately, I can't seem to locate the stables. Anyways, while we're looking for the stables, which could easily be on the other side of town. that's great. We want to go towards the armed guard standing by the pillory over there. I think that's what it is. I'm not really sure. Does this place even have stables? Well, we better just leave the horse somewhere. let's leave good old Paul back here. Hopefully no one notices him eating this hay. I assume this is hay. I think that's hay. Is that hay? I'm not really sure. Anyway, so the reason why we're taking a stroll through Ashford here is I wanted to update you guys on Daemon Silverfyre's story. Some of you brought it to my attention in the comments that his story didn't really make sense time-wise, that if Daemon were in fact the offspring of Meles the Monstrous, he'd be in fact 40 years old. He wouldn't be the nubile, fresh-faced individual that you see before us. And I thought, this is reasonable. I didn't think through all the particular details of Daemon's story because, in all honesty, you could probably spend forever trying to pan out every single detail. And you still might miss stuff, and then that would mean that you guys have to wait for the series to come out. And I thought, no, that'd be a crime. So, essentially, I updated Daemon Silverfyre's story. Essentially, what we talked about in the first episode is still canon. It's still kind of true. Only, the story... was more, it's been changed so that the story before is now the story of Daemon's father. Daemon's father was the offspring of Meles the Monstrous, who was legitimized by the tyrant of Tyrosh, which essentially means that Daemon here, he is still technically a Blackfyre, because what ended up happening is Daemon's father was legitimized by the tyrant of Tyrosh. Now, Daemon's father plays a very important role in Daemon's story here, simply because Daemon's father is kind of the reason why Daemon here is, he's the noble, honorable guy that he is. His father raised him to be very, very honorable, trying to extol the virtues of duty, mercy, compassion, all that. And Daemon took that to heart. Daemon's father primarily was that way because he wanted to be the exact opposite of Meles. Daemon's father wasn't stupid, but he was a simple man. He wasn't all that ambitious. He was content with being just a mere sellsword, getting various work based off of his reputation as the offspring of Meles the Monstrous. Daemon here was born of a different temperament. Is this armor guardsman? Do you have need of protection? Oh, I see. Me and one of my mates are looking for a master. Interesting. We may have to keep that in mind, good sir. Let's continue. And essentially, Daemon here is in Westeros to fulfill, well, his claim, he believes, on the Iron Throne, because he's much more ambitious than his father is. He's much more ambitious. Now, the reason Daemon showed up in Sunspear broke as hell is because, what is this? Is it, sir, did you just leave your... He just left his shop. He just abandoned his shop. This must be where the blacksmith works. Yeah, Daemon probably shouldn't be here. He shouldn't be behind the counter. That'd probably be against the rules. Anyways, so Daemon here, I want to find the tavern, but I want to find it on foot. Daemon here arrived in Sunspear, broke as hell because essentially his father didn't approve of his his coming to Westeros. His father didn't want his son to meet an early end, but his father saw the look in Daemon's eyes and knew there was no way he was actually going to stop his son. So he pretty much gave him leave to come to Westeros to fulfill his destiny. And the reason that I think we've already been here before too. The reason that Daemon took the name House Silverfyre is because his father had one condition. He pretty much gave Daemon an ultimatum. Are there people sleeping here? Awesome. I love it. And there's people sitting on railings too. Yeah, back in the old days, all these rooms would be empty. Really, really glad to see they actually have people sleeping in the rooms now. Very cool. Anyways, Daemon's father here gave him an ultimatum saying, you know, if you go to Westeros, I don't approve of it, and I will disown you if you do it. Under one condition, though, I will not disown you. And that was, he could not fly the colors of the Blackfyres. Why? Because Daemon's father loathed Meles the Monstrous, and he would not have his son flying the same colors as the monster of the Stepstones. So Daemon begrudgingly accepted and created his own house, House Silverfyre. Right. Not sure if I covered everything at Armed Villager. He must be mercenary. Hornhill Knight. Very cool. I'm not sure if I covered everything that I that I wanted to talk about, but I think it's more important that we get back to the task at hand. Armed a Villager. He's a... yes. So we can actually pick up some people here. I love to get this Southron sellsword here, but that'd be way too expensive. How much money do we even have? None. We have none. And I think that's why we're looking for Sir Loras Tyrell. We are broke as hell. We still do not have much money, but we will make more. We'll make more. Let's see. Let's talk to Sir Brian Fossaway. Do I know you? It is Damien the Taroshi at your service, sir. I am Sir Brian Fossaway, a vassal of the Regent Lord of Cider Hall. I see that you carry noble man's banner. Forgive my ignorance. It is good to make your acquaintance. Excellent. I wish to ask you something. I want to know the location of Sir Loras Tyrell. Let's see. Hearts Hill and Brightwater Keep. So he's still a ways south. Let's not do too many quests for the lords at the moment, because then that can get we can get kind of overwhelmed with that. Ooh, there's High Garden here. There's a good chance that High Garden probably won't look that good. We'll see. We'll take a look. It's important to if we're gonna be in the Reach, we need to be familiar with it's the seat of its capital, Sir Garland Tyrell. Very nice. Making ourselves known to House Tyrell would be good. Request entry to the castle. Excellent. Let's go look, take a walk around the Lord's Hall. It better be magnificent. Is it magnificent?
I like it. They did change it. Allery Hightower, Lord Mace Tyrell, Lord Paramount of the South.
Warden of the South, I think. And Lord Paramount of the Reach. Good sir, I offer you my services.
I am Lord Mace Tyrell, the ruler of the Reach, and the Lord of Highgarden, Cobble Cover, Hornrock, Warthford, and Bronze River.
I see you. Okay. He kind of likes us. Do you have any tasks for me?
No.
Oh, damn it. Someone did suggest joining a retinue, and that is it is a way to get money, especially if you're lowborn, but it's honestly not that interesting. Not from a player's perspective, and I can't imagine it being interesting for the viewers. They did change Highgarden. I like it. Can we go over here? I am being terrible, trampling over people's flowers and such. That's definitely going to endear them to the Damien here. Look at this. This is awesome. I like it. Who are these people? Galleon of Kui, the Maester, and Elena Redwine. Ah, yes. Is that some... Right. It makes sense that I can't access that chest. It's not Damien's. It belongs to the Lord of the castle. Is there anything important over here? I'm not really sure. We're getting really, really distracted, but I am really pleased that they changed Highgarden. Before, it was just a silly little castle, like every other generic castle, and in some places they just... Like Sunspear. Sunspear, for example, it's just kind of a generic walled city. It's not really interesting or anything. Let's not walk on the flowers this time. Let's actually take the path, like a reasonable man would. Go around here. And we need... Maybe we do need to accept the money for that bounty, because... Oh, come on. I can't walk out here? All right. Let's take a walk around the courtyard. Kind of immersion break, but that's all right. Not that bad. And now I have my hood on. And it is still dark. Ooh. Oh, they even modeled some of the towers off of the show. I like it. It is kind of generic, though, inside the keep. And those towers are badass. I want Highgarden. I want Highgarden now. Although, maybe they should clean up some of these rocks. And I'd love to see, like, actual people walking around the courtyard. But I'm not sure how, I love the towers. Would have loved to see a larger keep, though. Anyways, that is the capital of the Reach. But we must press on. Let's go south. Ah, there he is. There is our man. Sir Loras Tyrell. Well, Damien the Taroshi. About the task you gave me. I found Alan the Bold hiding at Holy Hall and gave him his punishment. We did, sir. We did. And we'll all be a lot better off from gaining the level. Very nice. Without him, thank you, Daemon the Taroshi, for removing the long festering thorn from my side. It's good to know you can be trusted to handle things with an appropriate level of tactfulness. A bounty I promised, and a bounty you shall receive. 300 coins and not a copper less. We need that money. But I think Daemon here would hold to his honor more. I think if he were to take this blood money, it would shame his father and his bloodline. So, unfortunately, we can't accept it. No, honor. Honor's more important. This is blood money. I can't accept it. You're a man for whom justice is its own reward, eh? As you wish it, Damien the Troshi, as you wish it. An honorable sentiment to be true. Regardless, you've my thanks for ridding me of that dishonorable. Nay, we've gained honor. Very nice. And that honor is what will endear all of Westeros to us. You all just wait. We are building a foundation. Is there anything else I can do for you, sir? You probably know that I'm the lord of the village of Holy Hall. Oh, shit, we were just there. However, it's been months since Holy Hall has delivered the taxes and rents due to me as rightful lord. Apparently, the populace has grown unruly lately. I need someone to go there and remind them of their obligations and to persuade them if they won't listen. If you go there and raise the taxes they owe me, I will grant you 1/5 of everything you collect. This is a great way for us to get money. I'm not sure how honorable it is, but it is a way for us to get money, and we are following the law. So we will agree to this. That doesn't mean that we have to go back to Holy Hall, but it will be a lot of money that we can potentially make. A fine offer, sir. We have an agreement. We must endear ourselves to the Tyrells. It is the... Ah, yes, it is morning. Dawn is upon us. We should probably... Let's see, 91 gold. It would probably take 10... How much gold would it take to recruit people here in the Reach? Holy shit. Have I not been leveling us up? I might have been forgetting to level us up here. So last episode, I made the comment that our agility is very, very low, and it is, in fact, really, really low. So we need to get this up higher. Ah, there we have it. But do we need shields? I don't know. We don't really have a shield. Are we going to be more of a two-handed character or a one-handed? Ugh, decisions. I like both.
I think Daemon would be sort of a knight. Sort of a knight, so maybe a shield would be good. Shield would protect us. Of course a shield. What am I saying? A shield would protect us from ranged stuff. And as we're charging in with our gallant knights of Old Town, we'll need to be able to absorb things with our... let's get our athletics up a little bit, too. Need to be a little bit faster. Pole arms. I'd kind of like to spread these out a little bit. You know, just a little bit. Be a little bit more even. Normally, I just pump it all into one proficiency, but I'll be a little bit more even about this. I want Daemon here to be as balanced as possible. There we go. Excellent. I am. There's really not that many bandits around here. I like it. Makes me feel safe. Cannot say the same about Sunspear. I'm not Sunspear. Dorne. But there probably are bandits here somewhere. I'm just not sure. Right. So when we get here, when we collect the taxes, the peasantry will not like us, and they may actually attack us. But I have faith that we'll be able to. We'll be able to handle ourselves. We proved that we could handle. Armed thugs in Ashford. I think we can handle the peasantry. Maybe. It all depends. The farmers here are a lot stronger than they are in Vanilla. In Vanilla, they're a joke. Here, they're actually a threat, especially to a beginner character like, our man here. But we will see. We will see. Maybe they won't do anything. It'll take us 3 days because our one skill is zero. Is that looting? I'm not really sure. Not really sure. So once we have money, we need to pretty much begin recruiting guys ASAP, as soon as possible, and start building some renown. The people of Holy Hall are outraged at your demands and decry it as nothing more than extortion. They're getting very restless, and they may react badly if you keep pressing them. I will continue, because if we agree to reduce your collection by half, yes, Loras Tro will be very upset if we do that. We must ignore them. We must ignore them and listen to our liege. I know the peasantry don't like it, but they are required to pay taxes. Unfortunate for them, but that is the agreement. Look at all that money. We're gonna get 1/5 of this. Now we could, if you wanted to be dishonorable, you could just take all this money for yourself, and then just piss off the guy who who you took the quest from. But we're not gonna do that. Daemon the Taroshi is he might be a foreigner in these lands, but he is a man of honor, and his word matters. Anyways, we need to figure out how much recruits will cost, and then we need to get them immediately, ASAP. Even if it is just like a handful of guys, because, well, the sooner we train them, the better. I'm not really sure if the recruits from the Reach will eventually turn into Old Town Knights? Ah, there we are. You've collected 2,975 coins and taxes. Excellent. The people, they're indifferent, but they are leaning towards negative. Hopefully we won't be required to... Oh god, he's right here! Wow, what good fortune! About the task you gave me, here are all the taxes from Holy Hall. It comes up to 2,000, yes. And what did we get? We lost 2,000, so what, we made 600 there? Well done, Daemon the Taroshi, very well done indeed. You were truly the right man for the job. I promised you 1/5 of the taxes, so that amounts to 595 coins. Very nice, very nice. If you give me that, you may keep the difference. A good result for everyone, eh? Yes it is. Cooperative, I like it. He has no more tasks for me. Let's see. Tell me about your skills. I want to know the location of someone. What are you and your men doing? We're traveling to Uplands. I see. What is the realm doing? There's no campaign currently in progress. We are currently at peace. That's good to know. War will come. War will come eventually. How goes the war? They're not at war with anybody. We'd like to cement a lasting alliance with your house. That would be a bit presumptive to ask that, but that may become something in the future that Daemon looks into, because after all, marriage is a thing in this game, and it can be very, very good. It can be very, very beneficial, but we will have to see in time. Perhaps a wedding, marriage into House Tyrell. Well, we wouldn't be marrying into their house. We would be marrying House Silverfyre and the Tyrells, and that could potentially be very advantageous for us. On the location of someone, Lord Mace Tyrell. Are there any other Tyrells? Oh, there's the Tarleys, too. Sir Garland Tyrell. Okay, well, you know what? Margot Lannister. Oh, I thought her name was Maggot. Maggot Lannister. Nope, just can't read. God. God damn it. All right. Holy Hall was... We've kind of pissed them off. Are they around... Now we need to start building our power base around Old Town, Ashford, and Tumbleton. Right. So now that we're not doing work for Sir Loras Tyrell, I think maybe it would be best if we head to Old Town and then start doing work for some of the villages here. He's Sir Loras Tyrell's heading south anyways, but as much as I'd like to accompany him, I am much faster than he is, so we're not going to do that. We're actually going to bypass him. And the only reason I'm not working on Ashford right now is because I kind of want to see how we get Old Town Knights. I'm not sure if they're mercenaries or if you can build up to them through the troop tree. Ah, see, we've got some bandits there, some broken men, some... What would you call them? Deserters, pretty much. And we're going to go past Hornhill, where the Tarleys are, Lord Tommen Costain. And then we've got Old Town, Sir Baelor Hightower. Old Town is ruled by House Hightower. We may have to endear ourselves to them as well. But before we do that, I'd like to take a look at Old Town. I'm certain it will be quite glorious. I've actually been here before. What am I saying? I know it's glorious. Because I remember the... giant ass tower that's here. Wow. Hell yeah. This is what I'm talking about. We want to be respectful. Where should I leave my goddamn horse? Maybe in here? It depends. Who is this guy? Guildmaster Elbert. I see. I'm not sure where I should leave my horse. Let's just leave Paul here with the guards. I'm sure he'll be safe. Poor Damien. I mean, I say poor because he's got that silly hood on his head, and he looks more like a brigand than anything else. Look at this fucking city. Look at this amazing city. I love it. I want this city too. I think I want this city more than Highgarden now. That'd be cool as hell, have our capital be from... Ah, there it is. The Citadel. I love it. If it weren't an enormous library, I would certainly take it as my own personal, what would you call it? Stronghold. But look at this. This is amazing. Wow. This is awesome. This is awesome. Maybe one day we will create a new kingdom. But if we create a new kingdom, I think what would happen is that would make us an enemy of the Reach. Yes, it is, wouldn't it? Not good. We have to create a kingdom and be independent. We can't serve the Reach. Which unfortunately might make them an enemy, but we could, yes, so we wouldn't be able to take Old Town, unless, like, an enemy faction were to take Old Town, if the Lannisters were to somehow capture it, then we were to take it, instead. I'm not sure there's anywhere else we can really go, so I'm gonna go here to the tavern. Well, that is the sign for the tavern, but apparently the door doesn't, here it is. Excellent. So let's go see if there are any Old Town Knights in here. Probably, maybe not. City Watchmen, okay. Got some guards, that's always good. Sellsword Longbowman, Sir Roger Osgree. Do bards normally sing songs on tables? I mean, maybe they do here in Westeros. Maybe that's a thing that they do. Castle Guard, Lauren the Ransom Broker, Dorner Sellsword Spearman, we don't need you. Sir Felton Flowers, he sounds like a mystic merchant. Yeah. Guy doesn't have a shirt. Actually, you know what? I want to look at your inventory. Good day, my friend. I have some unidentified items with me. I will sell these items to you by the base price of them. You probably buy an item with a good prefix by a low, or buy an item with a bad prefix for a higher height price. What the fuck? Do you want to try your fortune? No. That sounds too risky. How much money do we have? I think we have like 600 maybe? Barely 600. Good old Hedge Knight. One day, sir, we will look just like you. But that day is not today. Some companions here. You look like you'll cost money. Sir Roger Osgree and Sir Felton Flowers. Now, they'd be good because they don't die. They won't die and they gain experience. But they are just one dude. And if we can get them into our company, we can name some subscribers / people in the comments section after these guys. Eventually. Not today because I can't do that in this episode. I'll have to look up how to do that again. It's been a long time since I've done that. Let's see how much these guys are asking for. Greetings, traveler. I am Sir Roger Osgree, a knight and a son of Standfast. Well met, Sir Roger. What does a noble knight knight of Standfast find himself doing in a tavern such as this? Well, how splendid. Yeah. If you want to just disregard him, you can click that. But I do kind of want to know a story. I'm the fifth son of my father, Sir Edwin. And as such, it seems to me being somewhat unlikely that I'll ever inherit anything of value, so I've been traveling the world these last 8 months trying to find a noble lord to whom I might swear allegiance. It has become a bit of a tradition that the youngest sons of the Osgree family ride. Oh, he is of House Osgree. Oh, I thought House Osgree was destroyed. I didn't realize they were still here. Family ride out on the day they received their knighthood. My family has proven itself to be quite a fertile one. Heh, I have uncles and great uncles, nephews and brothers in abundance. Might be old Walder Frey has fathered a brood that could rival that of a dozen cats, but my father is half his age and likely to outbreed him. Okay. My eldest brothers, Adamar and Duncan, are to inherit Standfast and Coldmoat, Duncan holding Coldmoat in Adamar's name, and my sister, Rohanna, has been promised to Sir Alan Ladybright, and thus stands to one day be the Lady of Brightfast, but that leaves little for my father's remaining children, so we must make for our own fortune. I am no Kingslayer, nor Knight of Flowers, but I do find myself somewhat adequate with a lance and sword. Ah, I could use you, sir. Maybe we'll use an extra sword in my company. Depends, how much money does he want? Indeed, you would do well to enlist me. Well, a fifth son, I am nonetheless a knight of Standfast and sure to perform most honorably. Excellent. Perhaps I'll even one day hold my own castle, following you, my lord. You seem one for the great deeds. Indeed, Damien is indeed destined for great things. Good, make yourself ready and be on our way. How much does he want? 1,500. Yeah. Sorry, sir. One day. Maybe one day. Yeah, we probably shouldn't be spending that much money on, on just companions at the moment. Okay, so there are no Old Town. Well, maybe there are. Maybe there are. We're just not visiting the right place. Potentially. But we're not going to do that. I do kind of want to visit the archives. The Citadel is where the Maesters convene, study, and train new members, and also the residence of the Archmajors. The Seneschal's Court is a great hall with stone floors and high arched windows. It's where the Maesters convene with laymen, where acolytes gather, and where the Gatekeeper controls access to the Seneschal, who is tasked with the government of the Citadel. The Archives, another section of the Citadel, contains the greatest collection of books and scrolls. That's great, but we have no need to go there at the moment. Damien isn't a stupid man, but he doesn't really have need for that right now. Actually, go back to Old Town. I want to see the castle. The lords. It's nice. Not quite as expected. That is a sweet rug, though. Question is, can Damien step through the head? Let's not do that. Let's not disrespect the lord. Lord Leighton Hightower with a silly hat. I like the armor sets. Yes. My lord, may I have the honor of knowing more about you? I am Leighton Hightower, the lord of Old Town, and one they call the Old Man of Old Town. Let the small folk have their names. It does no harm. Cute. Okay, interesting. Maybe Old Town can't actually be taken by someone else. Maybe. Let's talk to Sir Baylor Hightower of House Hightower. Do I know you? My name is Damien the Taroshi, at your service, sir. Vassal of the Reach and lord of Old Town and Honeyholt. Oh, so he is the lord of Old Town. Interesting. No matter, a brave man's home is all the world, or so they say. Interesting. He doesn't seem to really like us all that much, so I'm beginning to wonder, maybe he's not an honorable character? I think honorable characters like other honorable characters, and just like dishonorable characters are like dishonorable ones. Do you have any tasks for me? No. Unfortunate. We should discuss you in private. I'm not for going off the corners to plot. Well, I mean, just not with me, because, you don't really trust me, and I don't blame you. Now then, let's go see what we can do. Honeyholt. It would probably be... To get to Honeywine, would we have to go around this river here? No, we can actually cross through Old Town. Great. So I'm thinking maybe Honeywine, Donaldwood, Honeyholt, and Ivyhall might be... It might be good to start doing quests for these little villages here. Just to make them like us. Although I'm not sure if we can do all the quests. Let's see. Three Reachmen levies volunteer to follow you. Recruit for 30 gold. And there we have our first recruits. They cost 24 gold a week. We have more than enough money for that. They become Reachmen Crossbowmen or Reachmen Pikemen. And the levies themselves, they're not terrible. They can be terrible in certain instances. For example, because they only have broad shields and spears. So they're really good against cavalry, not very good in hand-to-hand combat. I've seen my fair share of Reachmen levies being torn apart by farmers, so we'll have to be careful about that. But once they level up, they become crossbowmen or pikemen. The Reach doesn't scream really, really good foot soldiers, anti-cavalry and crossbowmen. But that's why we're here in the Reach, to get those crossbowmen. Because if you get enough crossbowmen, you get enough of them, you won't have to fight hand to hand because you'll just kill the enemy. Meet the village elder. Yes. See if we can't do some good deeds. Good day, my lord, and welcome to Honeywine. I am the elder of this village. Excellent. Do you have any tasks to help? There's something you may be able to help us with, Daemon the Troshi, to add to all of our other troubles. Recently, the village has become home to a nest of smugglers who are based out of Ashford. They drink and carouse, not to mention being engaged in nefarious practices of smuggling. I am afraid a passing lord will happen upon them So he wants us to hunt down smugglers from Ashford. How does this... I forget how this quest works. I'm not sure if they're gonna, do they spawn outside of Old Town and then go to Ashford? We really do not have the men to do this. And if we agree to do something and we can't uphold... If we agree to do this and we don't, follow through with our promise, it will actually hurt our relationship here. So unfortunately, I fear I cannot accept this mission at the time. And that's just because we don't have that many men. And I think this mission is timed. Well, most missions are timed. Unfortunate. All right, so let's build up some more recruits here. Because, I mean, they're so cheap that we probably could get a really large... Oh, no one here seems to be willing to follow you, of course. Maybe if we talk to the village elder... a reliable man that can undertake an important mission. The wife of one of the farmers is taken by bandits a couple of days ago. The man is distraught. We cannot pay you, my lord, but you would always be welcome in our village if you could bring her back. The amount of the bandits asked for is 500 coins. You have 15 days to take the money to the bandits, who will be 15 days. Shit, those bastards says that they're going to rape the woman if they don't get the money by that time. Yeah, of course they would. Fuck. Can we raise enough men in 15 days? I'm not sure. I'm not sure. We could maybe pay that money, but that's all our gold. But at the same time, can we risk these bandits having this farmer's wife, isn't it? Bring back the wife. I think Daemon would feel honor-bound to do this. So I think we will accept. You know, smugglers who are carousing and making trouble for a village... Not as pressing as bandits who have kidnapped a man's wife and threatened to do terrible things to her if they don't receive the ransom. We will accept. Unfortunately, that means we need to get our ass moving. We got to get as many recruits as we can. Let's see. Okay, that won't... go back here to Honeyholt. And we probably lose a day since it's still so... Oh, yeah, I forgot the Arbor is here, too. Yes, the Arbor. We would have to cross the Red Wine Straits, but that could be a worthwhile place. One levy! Great. I don't know how many bandits are actually there. Where are they? Donald asked you to pay the ransom. They're near Tumbler's Hall. Tumbler's Hall. Show me. Are they really far away? Of course they're really far away. Yeah, they've taken her to the northern border of the Reach. Probably so they can escape into... Escape into the either the Westerlands or the Crownlands should things go bad. This group of bandits, they seem to be smarter than normal bandits. Now this might get a little metagamey, but it's probably best that we started that quest with only four guys, because I think it will scale how many bandits we're gonna face based off of how many soldiers are in our party. But that's speculation. I don't know if that's actually true or not. Great. If it is true, then we should be able to just overwhelm them with numbers. And because the levies here, the Reachman levies, we gotta be careful going through this forest here, because I can't really see. I could turn the camera, but then it's gonna become disorienting. So if my speculation is true, we should be able to overwhelm them with just sheer numbers. And because these levies carry giant... Oh god, what is this? Oh shit! Oh, bandits... Okay, I've got my axe, I've got my rusty sword, and there's two of them. All right, come on, you. Come on. Block. There we go. Top. Kick. Okay, he's dead. Oh, he's not dead. Uh-oh, they're attacking through each other. Come on, Daemon. Up top. There we go. Uh-oh. Okay. Up top. There you go. Ah! Come to me. Come to me. You knave! Oh, shit. Too early. There. Whoo! Oh boy. Damn. Got 100 gold. The bandits fall before you as wheat to a scythe. Soon you stand alone in the streets while most of your attackers lie unconscious, dead or dying. Searching the bodies, you find a purse which must have belonged to a previous victim of these brutes, or perhaps it was given to them by someone who wanted to arrange a suitable ending to your life. Ooh, that is quite the problem. And those bandits attacked us just as we were trying to recruit some people to our cause. Maybe they received word that a Taroshi was collecting levies, and they thought they could ambush us here. Or maybe it was just two peasants who decided to they don't want to be farmers anymore and they wanted to be bandits. If the bandits we're going to fight are armed just like them, this should be relatively easy. However, like I said, the levies only have spears. Could become a problem. Let's recruit more soldiers. We've got 4 more men. How many men can Daemon lead altogether? 44. Well, our weekly cost is already at 100. We can afford to pay them for 6 weeks. 13 men. Okay. Yeah. We really could use a shield. We could really use a shield. If we kill those bandits, we might be able to get a shield for ourselves, hopefully. And we might actually have to rest a little bit, too, because we're kind of wounded. All right, once we've made the rounds and we've gotten all of our levies here, we're gonna start heading, make our way north. And we're just going to bounce from village to village. And we will accrue... Well, I mean, we're almost to 20. Yeah, let's see what the upkeep looks like. Of course, nobody wants to join. That's fine. That is fine. Let's go to Bittersweet. I am kind of fond of the names of the villages. They're all like a flowery garden-esque. Is that a word? I'm not really sure. Bittersweet. That's more of a taste, isn't it? Maybe. I do want to see. We've got 7 days left. We probably need to get more food too. Well, I mean, we almost have 20 soldiers, and we're not even at 200 in upkeep yet. Let's continue. Let's go to... They're up here. So let's stop at Ashford. Let's go to Cockles Went first. Maybe we can buy some supplies from them. Because we do actually need to... Okay. Meet with... buy supplies. Yes. Bag of grain. How much would that cost us? 30 gold. I'll take it. We just need more food. Because we have... you gotta feed your soldiers and you gotta feed yourself. Really important. If you don't do that, your morale would... be terrible, and that actually affects your soldiers in battle. Are they okay? Village, the farmers aren't running from anything, so that means we're probably safe from the bandits. Let's go to the marketplace. Hopefully we don't get attacked. We won't. Basket of apples. Can they have some exquisite cabbages? Nothing like some exquisite cabbages. All right, that'll leave us with 500 gold. Now that we have 22 men, we are almost. We're almost to 200. Above average morale. I like it. We're actually going to camp in the night because we're going to camp in Ashford overnight because we need to heal, and I think it will make our morale better. I'm not really sure. It might not affect our morale, actually, but we do absolutely need to heal. All right. Beachberry. I think there's a couple of villages in this little cove here. I call it a cove, but it's more like, it's blocked off by the little rivers here. Greenberry, let's take that. Not take. What am I saying? Okay, so I think at this point we're just gonna overwhelm the bandits with numbers. Hopefully they have like 10. That'd be great if they only had 10. Wait a minute, didn't the farmer say he's not gonna pay us? Maybe. All right, I think we might need to chill on the recruiting now because we're getting closer to our max. Daemon's max in terms of leadership, and we're at the point now where we can only afford to pay them for a single week. So we need to be prompt about this. Although a lot of them are probably going to die, and I hate saying that. I hate imagining Daemon having to contemplate the death of his men, but it is what it is, especially when you are in the bloody business of the Game of Thrones. As the old saying goes, you either win or you die. What are you? Honorable men. Okay, he's just a hedge knight. Just a hedge knight. Right. So, as far as death goes, technically, Daemon cannot actually die. Oh, God, they have 30. They have 30 bandits. So, we only outnumber them by 2. Tumblr's Hall. How many soldiers will you give me? 6. Okay. That'll give us an advantage of 8. And we're on horseback, are we not? Yes. Okay. How much gold do we have now? 300. So we can only afford to pay them. When is the next pay period? Next wage is the 3rd of Casta, which is in 2 days. Okay. We outnumber them almost by 10. If we get 6 more, we'll outnumber them quite a bit. And we might need to. That would cost us 60. So we could afford to get 6 more men, but after this pay period, we have no money to pay them. Which means we might have to disband some of them. It depends. How many of them are going to die, though? How many of them are going to die? I want to check the time. When does this expire? Given on the 30th. Doesn't actually say when it expires. Interesting. They said if they did not get their stuff in 15 days, maybe the quest itself is the text says it's 15 days, but they removed the... Okay. Okay. We're at full capacity. We're at full capacity. The weekly cost is... Okay, we can't even afford to pay them. This is going to be really, really... how do I say this? This is going to be kind of... it's going to be close. This is going to be a close one. So let's actually go right outside to... What are those? Village farmers? Okay. It's dawn. I would like to wait till about midday just so that the battlefield conditions are better. You know, so that... Oh, shit. I can see burning villages in the Riverlands. Yep, the Riverlands are going to be burned quite a bit. They get paid tomorrow. Whoever survives might have to get disbanded, assuming that... We also don't have any money to promote anybody, but hopefully we can remedy that situation. But we do have quite a large party, if not... but they are quite inexperienced. Let's wait here. Just a little bit. Form up a little camp. Early morning. Morning. Okay, that'll be good enough. Let's go face off with these bandits here. Now, before I go and I do that, I want to say that technically Damien cannot die, but he can lose all of his army, which would destroy all of his progress. Some other people other YouTubers I've seen who have played the Mountain Blade, Clash of Kings, have done things like, what did Arcade Knight do? He had a system called the Seven, which is where he gave himself 7 lives, and every time he got wounded in battle, you know, he would lose one of his lives, and then if he lost all of them, he would lose the game. I'm not sure if we'll do that. It's probably a little too late to be speculating if we're going to do that or not. I did think that it would be interesting if depending on the context of the situation, it would depend on if Damien here loses the game or not. And I thought maybe, you know, for example, if he gets captured by bandits, then, you know, he'll eventually get free. But if he gets captured by the Lannisters, then he loses completely. You know, we'd have to roleplay that's the ending of the campaign, because there's no way the Lannisters would let a potential claimant to the throne go. They would just keep him in the dungeons forever. Some kind of system like that. Let me know in the comment. Ooh, I like the snow. I like the snow. Let me know in the comment section what you guys think would be appropriate. I'm sure a lot of you would say no. Don't ever let it end. Don't ever let Damien fall. But there have to be some risks. All right. I've dribbled on long enough. Let us free the miller's wife. Let us free her. Are you the one that brought the ransom? Quick, give us the money now. If they are armed like this guy, we've got this in the bag. No way. You release the woman first. You fool. Stop playing games and give us the money. The camera's panning out kind of freaky, but it's okay. Stop playing games. I had left the money in a safe place. Let me go fetch it. I have no intention to pay you anything. I demand that you release the woman now. You won't be demanding anything when you're dead. Ah. All right. Let us fight. All right. Everybody hold position. Hold position on me, hopefully. Why are you not? Okay, now they're trying to hold position? Okay, they're forming a line. Now let's go take a look at... Okay, 21 enemies versus 21 enemies. It seems that the enemy is on foot. Can we get into a good position? If we can get everybody up here, we can attack them as they cross the river. Unless they're ranged. All right, everybody follow me. Let's see. Actually, this little spot right here could be really, really good for us. They'd have to charge down. across a river. Okay. They are not that... Okay, some of them are ranged. Some of them are ranged. Let's pull back and get you guys out of the river. All right. All right, we should be safe from the shields. Not the shields, the arrows. And my goal is to kill the people who are going to charge up first. And then we'll deal with the... With the archers in a second. All right. Oh, missed. Oh, I missed. Oh. Okay. All right. Okay. Oh, I got shot. All right. Engage, everybody. All right. Come on. This little axe. You know what? I shouldn't be over here. I should be attacking the archers. Or at least making them not shoot anymore. Okay, that guy did have armor. I am not hitting anything. Come on. Just distract him. Distract him, Damien. Come on. He's got four of them. There we go. Yeah, spearmen, not doing so great in melee. Okay. This is getting hard to hit. New enemies have arrived. Okay. We have not received our reinforcements yet, which is actually A-okay. I think it's okay. I'm not sure. I cannot actually hit anything. Okay, that guy's dead. Come on. Oh, Paul's taking a lot of hits. Oh, come on. There we go. Give me one of these spears. Ah, okay. I think I'm hitting people now. Oh, Paul's really, really wounded. Paul is wounded. Actually, yeah, give me that shield. Ah, okay. Come on, you fool. There we go. Everybody on me. We will move forward as one. Okay. Those guys are mine too, right? Yes. I started to get concerned. I was like, oh, these bandits are a lot more armed. All right, as long as everybody's on me. Attack him. Kill this man. Ah, there we go. Fighting on foot seems to be... What the fuck? Oh. Come on, guys. Where is my protection? Protect your lord. Ah, there we go. Charge. Break rank. Attack. Ah, yeah, jumping axe. Axe attack. There we go. Kill the man. You see, this is the type of fighting that the Reachman levies are doing. They have to poke them with their little spears. And we are victorious. How many did we lose? 8 wounded, 20 dead, 30 dead. So we've killed all the enemies. Okay. Right. So we have had 20 deaths. Ooh. 20 deaths, 8 wounded. We killed all of the enemies. I killed 9 men. You gained 6 renown. Party gained 5 morale. Excellent. Miller's wife. Oh, my lord. Thank you so much for rescuing me. Will you take me back to my village now? Yes. Come with me. We're going home. Excellent. The battle is over. What do you want to do with the loot? Share it with your men. Claim it all for yourself. You can, but that's going to destroy our morale. It's going to make the men hate us. Leave it for your men. Leave the loot and bury the dead. Share it with your men. Oh, yes. This is what I'm talking about. This right here. Oh, apologies. Thick, heavy leather jerkin. Hell yes. I will take it. I'll take all these. And a heavy leather cap. Well, that's way better than our hood. Brilliant. Rusty one-handed axe. No. Tattered leather cap. Let's actually put my rusty sword. No, you know what? Let's hold on to this stuff because it's going to give us extra space in our inventory. Shoes. You got mail boots. You don't need any of that shit. So, I mean, Damien's armor is pretty good. He can actually take a few blows. Unfortunately, Paul, not so much. Paul actually has no armor. He has zero armor and can get hurt really, really easily. You can only afford to take one more thing, so that's what we'll do. We will return. We got 256 gold. Yes! Glorious! Glory! We have destroyed the bandits. We took some casualties. But it seems that most of the men are ready to be upgraded to crossbowmen. Unfortunately, I don't think we have enough money for all of that. But when we do, we will have a glorious crossbowmen army. But all that will have to take place in the next episode. Thank you all for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, be sure to like, comment, and subscribe as always. This has been Mountain Blade, a Clash of Kings. I have been the Golden Joeblivion, and until next time, I will see you all later.